हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस द जनरल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ फाइलम कॉर्डेटा एंड द फंडामेंटल थ्री कैरेक्टर्स ऑफ फाइलम कॉर्डेटा। व्हाट आर दीज थ्री फंडामेंटल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स? दीज आर द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द नोटोकॉर्ड, देन प्रेजेंस ऑफ डॉर्सल हॉलो नर्व कॉर्ड, एंड द थर्ड वन इज द फारेंजियल गिल स्लिट्स। दिस थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट फंडामेंटल कैरेक्टर्स आर प्रेजेंट विद द ऑल कॉर्डेट्स इन एम्ब्रियोनिक कंडीशन और इन एडल्ट स्टेज। नाउ वील डिस्कस द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कॉर्डेट्स। इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस द फाइलम कॉर्डेटा is divided into two groups. One is called as a acraniata and another group is called as a craniata. What is acraniata? Where the brain box is absent, that we called these animals, we called it as a acraniata. And in those animals, the cranium or brain box is present, that are called as, or that are grouped under the craniata. Now the acraniata, these are the protocordates. These are divided into two subphyla. One is a urocordata and another one is the cephalocordata. While the craniata is divided into two subphyla, one is without jaws, these are called as a agnatha, and another with the jaws, these are called as a gnathostomata. The phylum Chordata having the two subphyla, one is called as a craniata or another one is a craniata. These acraniates are also called as a protochordates. Proto means first chordates, and the vertebrata, these are the craniates or the craniata. These protochordates are divided into the important two groups, the urochordata and cephalochordata, the hemichordata that we have discussed in last semester, and thus we have to discuss regarding the only urochordata and the cephalochordata which having the true notochord. This urochordata is again divided into three groups or orders, that is the larvacea, acidacea and the thaliacea. And this is the vertebrata that is divided into agnatha and the gnathostomata. So what are the acraniates? These are nothing but the protochordates. These possessing the gill slits, notochord and dorsal hollow nerve cord, or at least traces of these in the embryonic condition or at any stage of the life cycle. These protochordates are exclusively marine animals. They live in the salty water or in the sea water. The name protochordates, it means what? The first chordates. As they are lacking the brain box or cranium, these are called as or referred as acraniata. And as the cranium is not there or absent, the brain is also not prominent in these organisms. The protochordates have the dorsal nerve cord, gill slits and steep supporting rod, that we called it as a notochord, which is the forerunner of the vertebral column or backbone in vertebrata. The protochordates differ mainly from the vertebrates not having the backbone. In protochordates, the notochord is there, which lies on the dorsal position, whereas in vertebrates, it becomes a vertebral column. The recent protochordates are thought to have evolved from same ancestral stock which gave rise to the vertebrates. The protochordates are exclusively marine, living in the salty water or the sea water or in oceans. The relatively small sized animals, these are lacking the cranium, thus called as a craniates. These are doesn't having the brain box, jaws, vertebral column, and paired appendages are absent. These are having the three fundamental characteristics of the chordates. What are these? The dorsal tubular nerve cord, the gill slits meant for the respiration, and the notochord that are usually present. The sexes may be separate or united. In those animals, the sexes are united. We called it as a hermaphrodites. These animals are solitary, colonial, free living, pelagic, that is the surface feeding, burrowing, or tube living forms. Then the next group comes, and what is that? That is the urochordata. What are the urochordates? The meaning of uro is the tail region, and the chordam is the cord. The notochord in urochordates is restricted to the tail region only in the larval condition. And in these urochordates, the notochord is absent. Why? Because when these larvae metamorphose, the tail gets shed off. And so in adult, there is a no notochord, or adult is characterized by the absence of notochord while the larva having the notochord. These are also referred as tunicates or tunicata because of presence of the tunic or a leathery skin or outer covering on their body. This is the example of the tunicata. And if you observe, this is tunicate. This having the what? One is an incurrent siphon from where the water goes inside. Then this is the pharynx. The endostyle, it is equivalent to the what? The thyroid gland. These are the pharyngeal openings. That is the pharyngeal gill slit. Most of the body is covered with the what? That is a by the pharynx. Then these having the what? The digestive system. That is the stomach. Then gonads, that is the ovaries or testes, then outer covering or the leathery skin, that is the tunic, this is the intestine, and the last part one is anus, it which opens into the chamber, and that we called it as the atrium, and water, it rushes outside or runs outside or expelled outside of the body by the excurrent siphon. So this is the what the basic how the structure or the basic anatomy of the what that is a urochordata. The urochordates, adult urochordate doesn't having the what the notochord, but in the what the larval stage they bears or they possesses the notochord. This is the urochordates or the anatomy of urochordate. Just we have discussed that is the water enters within the body through this oral siphon. This is the mouth, then water comes into the pharynx, and through pharyngeal gill slit that it entirely bars the what that is these gills, and then it comes or the whatever the food is whatever the water it is released outside from the gills to the atrium, and then it is released outside the body by the excurrent siphon. Then the whatever the food particles which are trapped by the what that is a pharyngeal mucus, it is passed on to the digestive system or the part of the gut, and then next to this that is it goes to the rectum and the what that is anus. Undigested food particle, it is released outside by the what that is a excurrent siphon, or that we called it as a atrial siphon. As you can see, the body is covered with the what, the tunic, or the what that is a leathery skin. The what it having the what they are the hermaphrodites or unisexual, and or that this is the presence of the both the gonads in this animal, that is a ovary as well as the testes. Then, what are the general characteristics of Eurochordata? These are exclusively marine and these are commonly called as the sea squids. The solitary or colonial and the sexes are united, that is the hermaphrodite. Body is covered with a cuticular tunic or the leathery skin, that is called as a test in adult. The notochord is in Eurochordata is present only in the adult stage while the larvae lacking the notochord. The dorsal tubular nerve cord is present in the larval form and it degenerates in the form of the small ganglion in the adult. The respiration in Eurochordata occurs by the gill slit and it occurs. The heart is on ventral side, simple and tubular, and most of the tunicates, these feed by filtering the sea water by pharyngeal slits, and these are the suspension feeder. They having the two openings in their body cavity through which the water enters, that is called as an incurrent siphon. This is the pharyngeal site or the through which water enters into the pharynx. And from pharynx, water goes outside through the atrial chamber. And this is the what? The excurrent siphon or the this J is a what? Excurrent siphon. Water enters to the incurrent siphon. Then it bars the entire gills. Whatever the food material, it is passed on to the digestive system. And then whatever the undigested food particles, these are released into the atrium. And the what remaining water, all that is it is expelled outside by the what that is a excurrent siphon. It having the what that is a both the gonads, that is the testes and the ovaries. It having the tunic or the outer covering or the leathery covering, that is the tunic, and the what the heart or the position of the heart, that is the where is the heart is a ventral site as in the what that is a vertebrates, and it is simple and the tubular type. The excretion in tunicates lack the kidney while metanephridial organs, and they have neural gland, pyloric gland and nephrocytes. The coelom or the body cavity develops into the pericardial cavity and around the gonads. And most of the tunicates are hermaphrodites. The tunicates life start as a larval stage that resembles the tadpole larva of the frog and exhibits the chordate characters. It contains nerve cord and a short notochord in the tail region, and as it is aquatic, the organs of respiration, these are the gills. As the larva reaches the maturity, it attaches to the sea bottom and it undergoes the retrogressive metamorphosis. That means the what the larva possesses, larva now loses its tail, and along with the tail it loses its notochord, and therefore it loses its progressive characters by losing its tail and most of the chordate characters. Only gill slits persist and it develops into a barrel-like or sedentary or non-mobile adult form. This is the tadpole larva of the Eurochordata or the Herdmania. This is the what? The 8 number is a what? The adhesive papillae through which it will attach to the substratum, and after that it will remain in a what? Vertical position. During the what the metamorphosis, this is the what 12 number structure is a notochord. During metamorphosis, entire tail gets shed off, and so that larva loses its notochord during the during the adult stage. While also the third number, that is a nerve cord, as the nerve cord is also running in within the tail, it also gets lost, and therefore the nerve cord it remain it as a small ganglion, and therefore the only chordate character or the prominent chordate character which remain in the adult is a what? The pharyngeal gill slits. So this is how the what are the characteristics of the EuroCall data. And this EuroCall data is again divided into three classes. The subphylum EuroCall data, it is divided into three subclasses. Class 1 is Acidiacea, second class is Thaliacea, and the third one is Larvacea. The three classes, the phylum EuroCall data, it is divided into how many classes? Three classes. One is Acidiacea, another one is Thaliacea, and the third one is Larvacea. The class 1 Acidiacea, it is divided into two orders. One is Enterogona and another one is Pleurogona. Then our class Thaliacea, it is divided into three orders. One is a Pyrosomida, second one is a Doliolida, and the third one is Salpida. And the larva class third, that we called it as a Larvacea. There are the two orders. One order one is a Endostylophora and another one that is a Polystylophora. So this EuroCall data, this is divided into how many classes? Three classes. One is the Acidiacea, another one is Thaliacea and the Larvacea. In next video, we will discuss the general characteristics and the classification of this EuroCall data and the characteristics of this class Acidiacea, Thaliacea, Larvacea along with the characteristics of the orders. Thank you.